Hello, MechWarriors! How is it going? Welcome to your daily dose of MechWarrior Online. Today I'm gonna play the Timberwolf, because the Timberwolf is also part of the challenge, and I want to give you a very simple and straightforward build that performs, for me at least, very, very well. So what am I going to do here? We have an Ultra Autocannon 10 and 6 ER medium lasers. Straightforward. It's a mid-range build, and as you can see, the rest is put into heat management. That build, that mech, stays in the fight forever. You can shoot without any heat problems, and you know, you over the time, you rack up damage, you get your KMDDs, and you also contribute to the team's effort of winning the game. Again, this is super straightforward, super simple, but simple isn't bad. That's the thing. I'm running the Timberwolf C here, because that one has the energy hardpoint in the center torso, and the rest of the Omnipods is Timberwolf Prime. You could also go for the left torso Omnipod of the, what is that, the A. If you don't have the C variant, you can buy this, because that has more energy hardpoints. Or you just leave out one medium laser in the center torso and put in a targeting computer. That would work as well. But you then only have 5 ER mediums. So, yeah, I think the C variant is what you need here. Apart from it, 3 tons of ammo and a lot of heat sinks, as I said before. Again, very straightforward. The skill build looks like this. I have the classic laser vomit loadout, so we go down here, get the laser duration nodes, and then we go to the right side to get the autocannon bumped up. We have the jam duration reduction, the magazine capacity, and yeah, as you can see, the additional cooldown and additional heat management down here. I'm running the left side of the survivability tree. We have a little bit of armor and skeletal density, which really helps, and we are running upper torso mobility. We have the 3 torso speed nodes here, which I find very convenient, especially on a Timberwolf, so getting that additional torso speed is very nice to have here. I'm running full cool run here, so my operations tree looks like this, although I have to say I misskilled a little bit. You don't need speed retention on Timberwolf. Hill climb is of course better, so this would be the better skill, but I was low on experience here, therefore I didn't respec it for the build. I'm skipping sensors here, because I just wanted to try how the build works with our sensors, and it works pretty fine. I have to say, you don't necessarily need that, and I'm going for a double cool shot to get even more DPS out to the battlefield, because your alpha strike is or your alpha heat, let's say alpha heat potential, is relatively high. The heat dissipation is great, but sometimes when you are in a fighting situation, you really need that cool shot, and having the cool shot twice is super, super handy. Yeah, and that's the build, everybody. I wish you all a lot of fun in the games, and if you have that, as always, don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And now it's time to hit the battlefield. Alright, first game of the day. We are playing the Rubellite Oasis, and we are playing Skirmish, which is actually pretty fine for us. We have decent heat management, so if I fire my lasers, I'm going up to 40% heat, but do you see how fast it dissipates again? This is the cool thing. So be careful with your alpha strikes, don't do it too often. Just take a little bit of time in between your shots and you are fine, even on hot maps. So what we want to do here is we want to stay at mid-range and deliver some fire support. We can of course peek and poke with our Ultra AZ-10 very early on, because it has a range of about 600 meters. That's great. And yeah, we're gonna go to probably low ground here. We're definitely gonna go now. Red smoke coming in. That was an artillery strike or an airstrike. You never know. It would be cool if the airstrikes and artillery strikes would be distinguishable from each other. If the, I don't know, airstrike color would be blue or green, and artillery would be red. So it makes it so that you can evade better. You know where to go. In an artillery strike, you just get your distance. On an airstrike, you just make a sidestep. Easy. But anyway, let's find ourselves some enemies to kill. We have an assault mech up there. We have another guy there. It's 900 meters. That means that our Ultra Autocannons deal half damage at that range. Okay. There's a guy. Let's poke him. Yeah, this is just, again, very, very safe early game. I do not want to overextend right now. We are playing skirmish. That means that we do not have any other objective than killing the enemy. That is so important, guys. Keep that in mind. Just figure out a plan. Fight on your conditions. Go where you want to fight. Take the advantageous positions, and don't go necessarily to the center of the map if you don't have to. That is the skirmish in a nutshell. Guy, we hit that guy. We're gonna take the high ground left side. Guys, let's take high ground Fox 6. We don't have to be in the bowl down there. New target acquired. Yeah, so let's see. We don't have that many mechs here, only a dragon, and if the enemy decides to do the same move, we have kind of a problem here. Okay, that is... Yeah, there they come. That was great. Yeah, it was actually okay. It was a good trade for me, because I could bring my whole laser burn to the Hellbringer. Enemies coming up from Gulf 6 into Fox 6, guys. Prepare firing line here, please. Okay, team ignores me. Never mind, I'm out. Okay, that's not working, guys. We need... I don't know. You're going low ground, guys, right side? Then let's do it together. We're getting pushed on top, Fox 6. Okay, I couldn't bring my autocannon to the point. It was obstructed by terrain. I really want to help, but... Can do this here. Only the arms. We have one Timberwolf, but I think there is so much to come up there. They have so many enemies. Half of my team decided going low ground, which I do not really approve of. Shall I drop here? I'm very much considering dropping and helping him out in the low ground, because on top here, it is kind of risky. However, we have a King Crab. Okay, guys, Fox 6 top. I'm gonna push around into Fox 5. Never mind, we have an enemy behind us. Let's get rid of the Cheetah. Okay, cool shot. Okay. Didn't you see the Cheetah? You were... Okay. No, actually, they're following the call, which is actually pretty good, because they defended my back there. So, thanks, guys. Thank you very much. Still pushing forward. So, we go for the right side of that guy, because a lot of dragons are running XL these days. Yeah, we take that. Here comes the Cheetah again. We have one enemy in our midst. Don't chase the Cheetah. Focus on the Zeus. Okay, this guy is gonna die soon, and he is not that scary anymore. So we're gonna focus on the Nova here. So switching targets to the squishy ones. That was blocked by the corpse here. That's always annoying when that happens. Let's take out the side torso. Autocannon is jammed. Can we take the Nova, Lima, please? Okay, we're gonna go for it now. Center torso. Not enough, but almost. Good, we got him. Cool. 5-1, looking solid. The missiles are gonna be an issue. But my team is wrecking now. Still pushing forward into Gulf 5 now, Gulf 6. Alright, let's get an angle on the dragon, and we are in perfect range for dealing maximum damage here. Unfortunately, we have another jam. And I'm getting shot. Where from? This guy. Okay, we got the legs. That should be it. Good. So, was a very nice sneaky backstabbing attempt here. I have to give him that. I wasn't aware of that guy. Absolutely not. Use the arms. Oh, no. I don't want to draw attention here. Nope. And here comes the missile. Yeah, the missile rain. That is what I was talking about earlier. In my condition, I have to be extremely careful. And missiles can just make my day a bad one. Okay, we gotta fall back to second line. Second, third, fifth line. Because I am down to 40%, funnily enough. So my, what is that? The right torso is still good, but my center is so damn squishy here. So I want to try to get an angle on the enemy where they are not aware of my position. However, I need to be in the fight really quick. Okay, let's see. It was a little blinding. Come on. Good, we got that guy. Ooh, is that gonna be it? Is that my death? And what I... either me or him. I had to fire that. Yeah, overheat killing myself, but... In that condition, with my center torso, if he would have scraped my center, I would have been dead anyway. So I took the kill and died at the same time. Cool. That was a very intense round. I liked that. That was such a great round, guys. We had 5 killing blows. We have 5 assists, 4 chemos damage dealt, 855 damage, and 12 components destroyed. 9,000 XP. Nice round, everybody. Let's go over to the next round and see how this will go down. Alright, second game of the day. We are playing... oh, it's sold. On Frozen City. I just realized. But we got a double cool shot now. We've got an additional UAV because the last game was so good in terms of XP and I could finally master my max. So I needed some... like five, yeah, it was 5 points missing that I invested into the consumables now. So we have a very, very good DPS here. We are playing Frozen City, which is great. Look at the dissipation, it's so good. And the double cool shot on top of it, it just makes the mech so super cool. So let's go ahead and try to find an angle on the enemy. It seems that we are doing NASCAR, or let's say a Delta 5 push. Because you know, my assault mechs are going there, and we're gonna go with them. Movement, go, Fox 5, Golf 6. That is, yeah. Let's do that. I was a little bit confused by the Golf 6 announcement here, but yeah, let's go ahead and try to push there. If my teammates are coming, so that's the important thing. What are you running there? What is that? Gauss Warhawk? What? No, that is some LB... What is that? Okay. Interesting. I have never seen that before on a Warhawk. So, let's see. Half of my team is staying. That's not good. Guys, we have an active push into the Fox 5 area. So, you coming? I'm just saying. You guys on the base? Delta 5 into Echo 5 into Fox 5 is what we do right now. Like, half of our team. And let's not string out too much. Okay. Oh yeah, they are pushing as well. But also they have some stragglers there. The King Crab getting eaten up by our medium mech, the Storm Crow. That's good. Try to get to the King Crab as fast as possible.
I'm going.
Okay, we go the direct way now. I believe half of the enemy team is pushing towards our base in the Fox line. So we can actually try to get into the fight here. And then we have to be super quick and have to turn around like crazy. Okay, here's the King Crab. It's getting shot at, but there's also... Oh yeah. There's Cyclops. Hello, Cyclops. Hi. Yeah, I'm shooting you. Great kills, guys. Let's get back to base and defend that. We're getting pushed a lot. Let's help out our guys in Echo 5, Echo 6. Oh, they are coming back as well. There's gonna be a big fight in the bowl here. Okay, we're gonna go for this here. I know it wasn't optimal, but I have to be extremely careful here. Just because I am the one on the front line here, more or less. Not even more or less. I am the one on the front line, and we have a jammed autocannon again. Damn it. Unjam, come on. I need all of my weapons. There we go. Come on. And again, another jam! Okay. So, again, that's gonna be a big fight down below. Why do they... this guy. Didn't see him. But now that I know that you are there, man, I can punish you for what you did. I know that my lasers are not all on point, but... I'm gonna shoot anyway, because I want that side torso down. You know what? I'm gonna push him. We need to get close to get all of our weapons, and... There we go. Get that. And he's down. Good job. Okay, now the guys on our left. Timberwolf Hotel. Down. Good. 5-1. Looking very solid here. So the pick-off of the enemy assault mechs here was really good. Stormcrow coming in. Stormcrow going down. Gonna go for the Highlander now. He's down. He didn't move. I expected him to move. And now I'm crit heat. And that's it. We captured the base. Yeah, we captured the base. I was like, focus. And then, okay, objective. That's how it goes down sometimes. Man, that was a crazy, crazy fight. But that escalated. And it was so good that we actually put the aggression on the enemy's base while they were trying to push our base. We got two kills early and it spiraled down from there. Cool. Now, we had one killing blow because everybody was going super crazy, but it's okay. We've got five assists. We got two KMDD CD, 730 damage, and 6 components destroyed. I like the build, guys. I have to say I'm a big fan of the build. It is super simple but super straightforward. And if you like the video, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. If you want to support the channel, then go down below to the description. There is the link to my Patreon page. And I hope to see you on the battlefield, everybody. Goodbye.